After winning the election, IK had a lot to do to fulfill the promises of a change that all Pakistan was hoping for. Today, after more than 2 years since he's in power, we'll be taking a deep dive how he became what he stood against. After returning in mainstream politics from 2011, Imran Khan ran one of the best political campaigns in Pakistan's history, based being different from traditional leaders. Killing the corruption, no need to mention, which has been backbone of Pakistan's politics from decades. Most importantly, being an active leader that knows the problem of people, which none in past were. He soon became the hope for people.
स्टंटेड ग्रोथ है, दिमाग नहीं उनके पूरे होते, कद पे नहीं पहुंचते, क्योंकि खुराक पूरी नहीं मिलती, क्योंकि डाकू इस मुल्क का पैसा चोरी करके बाहर ले जाते हैं। ये डाकू मुल्क को दोनों हाथों से लूट रहे हैं, हमारे पास पैसा नहीं है मुल्क चलाने के लिए।
इवन आफ्टर लूजिंग इन 2013, ही हैड बिकेम अ मेजर प्लेयर एंड इमरान डिडंट सिट डाउन टू वेट फॉर द नेक्स्ट इलेक्शन एज एवरीवन एल्स डज, but kept on fighting against the PMLN's government, and thanks to Panama, removed Nawaz from being Prime Minister and also from politics. Imran Khan, being bold, covered every problem Pakistan's people faced. People had high hopes that they may finally have a true leader. Nawaz and Maryam being removed from politics, Bilawal being a joke, people supporting Imran Khan. In 2018 elections, no one could stop him from winning. Before we go any further, let's cover the pattern Pakistan's every democratic government follows. Basically, there are three stages. First, superactive state. In this state, newly powered government will be super active. You will see promise being initiated and super criticism on last government, how they give the country in a ruined state to them.
The past 5 years were so harsh that we felt we were dead.
This state lasts for 1 year at most. Second, dead state. After 1 year, political government is dead. None of public issues are covered. It doesn't matter if complete Pakistan comes out, let alone action, they want even pass statements. This is the time corruption starts, and to hide that, there will be some political dramas. Third, revived state. After 4 years, government comes out claiming that time is running out and doing promises for things they will do if win the next election. Imran Khan get perfect mark in this state, as Khan did legendary speeches after winning, and there were plans such as 100 day agenda to initiate the change. Some of most highlighted points in that agenda were NAB reforms, civil service reforms, FBR reforms, access to justice legal reforms, Naya Pakistan housing program, 10 billion trees project, clean drinking water plans, action against Kabza mafia, health system blueprints and education system blueprints. Things seem to be going in the right direction. After a year passed, it was time to see changes of what Imran started. Basically everyone, including me, who supported Imran, was hoping to see Imran won't go in dead state. He would be responding to public problems, making changes for complete 5 years. But did he? Instead, what we got was no different from past governments. All promises Khan did weren't real. Let's take a look at what actually happened to the projects that 100 day junta started. NAB reforms. NAB, the most useless department Pakistan has, got no reforms apart from being written on paper. Basically, NAB starts a case, take millions and billions from corrupt people and let them go. I don't remember a single action taken against any corrupt leader by NAB. Most recent example being Asim Bajwa. how he got a land cruiser for 50 lakh and 55 acre of land for just 50,000. This definitely was a corruption case, but neither Imran nor Naib did anything. Zardari. He has been in 6 cases of corruption, starting from 2012's money laundering case. But has anything happened to him? Definitely no. Naib and Zardari has been playing hide and seek with Naib's eyes being closed. And then we have programs such as Chief Justice Dam Fund, PM Flood Relief Fund, which definitely Naib should take a look at. But have they? No.
तक डैम की तामीर के लिए क्यों नहीं दिया गया? उन्होंने कहा कि जिन्होंने पैसे दिए हैं ये उनके साथ नाइंसाफी है और उनको चाहिए था कि अगर ये पैसे डैम फंड्स के लिए नहीं लगा रहे तो जिन्होंने पैसे दिए थे उनको वापस करते।
Health system. PM has made a program to distribute health cards, which is quite controversial. Why not regulate and better government-owned hospitals, which are worst in the world, instead of wasting millions in vote-grabbing tactics? Education system betterment. This was completely forgotten. Pakistan has highest numbers of degree-holding illiterates in the world. 10 billion trees. This one is just 160 million going to corruption. Financial situation betterment. Shahid Khan explains it in the best way possible. Every financial decision is made to benefit the rich and make people poorer in Pakistan. Dollar was 122 when Khan joined and now it is 167 and going up. Investors are pulling their money away, rupee being highly unstable. Simply put, every common person is 50% poorer than they were in 2018, as everything has gone up by 50%, but 0% increase in salaries. Lastly, our finance ministers are there to tell loopholes and how to hide corruption trials. That's why Asad Umar was removed and replaced by Abdul Hafiz Sheikh, someone who is destroying Pakistan's economy from years. Access to justice reform. It has been more than 2 years since our respected PM told us how they would write justice system.
Taqatwar kamzor, jo is mulk ke kanoon ke khilaf jayega, uske khilaf hum action lenge. मैं इंशाल्लाह आपको साबित ये करके दिखाऊंगा।
But the system is dead as ever. Example from this month are Jiuli, how she was kidnapped by police for raising voice against mafia, and no FIR against Hayat killers, and no single word from any political leader.
कोई है पूछने वाला? किससे वज़ीर आला का बाप का ये जुरत है कि ये पूछने? किससे आईजी का बाप का ये जुरत है कि वो पूछने? किससे डीसी का बाप का ये जुरत है कि वो पूछने? ना अदालतें, ना एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, ना मुंतखब वज़ीर, ना मुंतखब वज़ीर आला, ना मुंतखब वज़ीर आज़म।
Every sort of problem comes, people protest, but no action and no response from government. This is how justice looks like in Pakistan. Lastly, I would like to say, Imran, be what you were before election. We support you, not your party. Trust me, if you'll speak about our problems and try to change the corrupt system, no opposition nor your own party can remove you. As Recep Tayyip Erdogan could not be removed by even military, while people on his back.
लोगों के पास साफ पीने का पानी नहीं, लोगों के पास घरों में सीवरेज सिस्टम नहीं, नौजवान बेरोजगार फिर रहे, सरकारी स्कूलों में तालीम ऐसी है कि पढ़ के भी बच्चे बेरोजगार फिर रहे हैं, अस्पतालों में चार चार लोग एक बिस्तर पे पड़े हैं,